freeintromusic.com layout track.
Hello viewers, welcome to another delicious recipe video. This is a video of how to make bisibilla bath or sambar rice at home. This is a spicy, delicious blend of masalas, rice, dal, vegetables, nuts, and ghee for tempering. This is originally a Karnataka-based recipe, but it is a popular dish in all South Indian states. Try this recipe video at home and let us know how it came. These are the basic ingredients needed for the recipe. The preparation for the special homemade bisibilla bath masala is being explained in another separate video. Check out the recipe video link in the description below. And we want to mention a special thanks to Urmi's Kitchen contribution to this video. Check out their page on Instagram. Based from Karnataka, they have a very well fan base for special Andhra recipes. Now let us go into the recipe video. We take 2 cups of ponni rice in a pressure cooker along with 1 cup of tur dal or sambar dal. Rinse it well with water. Add about 5 to 6 cups of water. Add 1 teaspoon salt. Add some non-salted peanuts. Close the pressure cooker lid and cook it for about 15 minutes. We see that the rice and the dal are well cooked along with the peanuts. Now set it aside. Now we prepare the tamarind paste. Soak the tamarind in some water for about 5 minutes and mash it well with your fingers to separate the seeds and remove them. The remaining tamarind paste is set aside. Next is the jaggery syrup preparation. Again, we take about 1 to 2 tablespoons of jaggery in boiling water. Continue stirring for about 5 minutes. Once the jaggery is fully dissolved, filter it using a metal mesh and set the syrup aside. Next, we prepare the vegetables. Vegetables are our choice. We take usually about 2 or 3 vegetables of our choice. In this video, we have explained how to cook beans, carrot, and drumsticks. You can use any vegetables ranging from brinjal, radish, pumpkin, green peas, cooked capsicum, and others. Take the vegetables in a cooking pot along with some water. Add 1 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1 teaspoon of garam masala, and 1/2 teaspoon of salt. Mix them well and bring the water to a boil for about 5 minutes till the vegetables are well cooked. Preserve the water and do not throw it away. Next, we keep things ready for the tempering. Take some small onions or shallots, preferably mustard seeds, curry leaves, red chilies, and 1 or 2 green chilies if you want it more spicy. Keep some ghee ready for tempering. Now we go to the final step. We have already prepared the rice and the dal, the bisibilla bath homemade masala, The vegetables are ready. There is jaggery paste, turmeric paste, ghee for tempering, along with the last ingredients. Now all this is ready and we go into the final step of mixing them one by one. First we add the vegetables along with the water to the rice and dal mixture. Continue heating in low flame while you mix them well. Add about 4 tablespoons of special homemade Bisabilabad masala. Again, the Bisabilabad masala preparation is explained in a separate video, which you can check it out in the description below. Add 4 teaspoons of tamarind paste. Add 4 teaspoons of jaggery syrup. Continue stirring and mixing in low flame. Check the salt at this stage and add if necessary. Now for the final step of tempering, take 1 whole tablespoon of ghee in a cooking pot in low flame. Once the ghee has melted, add all the ingredients for tempering: onions, curry leaves, mustard seeds, red chilies and green chilies. Stir in low flame till the onions are well cooked. It may take about 2 to 3 minutes. Now temper the Bisabilabad as the final step. When the tempering is done, tasty Bisabilabad is ready. Serve it along with some potato chips. Try this recipe and if you like it, do add it in your comments. Like, share and subscribe to this channel. More exciting recipes are on the way. Thanks for watching.